three family members of Goretti Chitutu, the Minister for Karamoja Affairs, were on Sunday arrested for allegedly selling relief items meant for the people of Karamoja. It is alleged that those arrested include the minister's mother, her brother and nephew, who were found in possession of government-owned iron sheets that were meant to be given to residents in Karamoja as relief items.
The minister is a custodian of resources allocated to Karamoja. She is the one to handle them very carefully. But now, somebody who has been a senior minister, it means that she has been also doing it in other ministries. That she has been leading.
While addressing journalists at Parliament today, members of the Karamoja Parliamentary Group came out to condemn theft of relief support meant for the people of Karamoja and demanded that the two ministers for Karamoja Affairs, including Goretti Chitutu and Agnes Nandutu, step aside and pave way for investigations into the matter.
The Minister for Karamoja Affairs, Honorable Dr. Mary Goretti Chitutu, and the Minister of State for Karamoja Affairs, Agnes Nandutu, please, in God's name, step aside to allow proper investigation into this matter. You have brought shame to us. It's the honorable thing to do. How can iron sheets meant for Karamoja find themselves 300 kilometers away in Bugishu, on top of the roofs of houses, when the people who are suffering there are waiting for them? This is not how we run a country. It's like putting a rat in a garden, in a granary of groundnuts. You think the granary is sealed and your seed is safe. Kumbe, the rat is inside.
Unfortunately, the two ministers have not been attending meetings. Little did we know that they were only waiting for us to process supplementary budgets, and then they would actually jump over the monies.
MPs representing Karamoja areas have called for a forensic audit into procurement and distribution of iron sheets and goods which were sent to Karamoja.
We really call for a forensic audit on both the procurement and distribution of iron sheets, of goods, to the intended beneficiaries, and also to audit the stores of food for the food for the children in Namalu prison farm to find out, is it true that all the food is there, or is it true that all the food is not there? We are just getting this information from various sources.
The MPs claim that funds which the government has sunk in Karamoja in recent years have not had an impact on the ground. They wondered how iron sheets meant for poor people in Karamoja ended up in Bugisu in the first place, while the intended beneficiaries are still waiting for the same to be delivered.
The issue of iron sheets for Karamoja has been dilly-dallying for too long, only for us to read from the press that the iron sheets that were meant for Karamoja has gone elsewhere. It is a big shame. It is not only iron sheets. We have even had goats procured for our poor people of Karamoja, but those were also mismanaged.
Karamoja MPs have asked the government to consider disbanding the Ministry for Karamoja Affairs should the accused ministers find it difficult to step aside.
It's so gross. And so I am saying, if stepping aside is not possible, if it is an option that they cannot take, maybe we disband that ministry, because it has lost its purpose, the relevance of it. You Ugandans have been complaining that a lot of money is being pumped in Karamoja and Karamoja is remaining the same, or even getting worse, having your streets in the city filled up with our people who are begging. And now you have seen the evidence where the money is going. It is actually not going to the region. Should we still continue investing in the same?
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.